Hi, this is Nilsson Lyman, and I come here today to show how to test multiplayer within the Ocean project. And for this, we have a couple things. First thing is to identify the level you want to run multiplayer. In this case, this is the Iceland map. And another thing that you want to check is going to the project settings, input, here inside engine input, and look down all the way, your console key. The default is the tilde key. As I am using an international keyboard, I'm just trying to look for something a little better for me. It is okay if you can't bring your console when you're executing the game. You just have to change the console key for the one it fits better for you. I'm using this this key here. It works better for me. Another thing you want to check, and I ask you guys to copy this part from the level blueprint and begin play. Add a little bit of the streaming pool size. Okay. And for the second sequence, game user settings, disable VSync, no frame rate limit. In this case, value 3 here for the scalability means epic. Select for the screen, full screen mode, windowed. We have the options for full screen, windowed full screen, and windowed. Choose just windowed. This is better for us to test the multiplayer. And for the screen resolution, type something. Yeah, because we will open two windows in our desktop, each one to simulate the host machine and the client machine. And I'm using here some sort of any low resolution you can have here. This could be like 720 by 4800, okay? And apply settings at the end. This is all the this other portion here is not necessary, just this one I have showed you guys. So you hit compile, save, and I have done this already, so it will be faster in my machine than yours, so you have to wait a little bit for this. It is to package the solution to an executable. So you come here to file, package project, Windows 64. You pick any folder you want to. Hit OK. You can follow the packaging process in the output log. It takes a while. Some stuff here you see. A lot of things are done already, so it will be faster for these two to complete. Sorry for that. We are in some guys been working here, and that is a lot of dust. It's like affecting to me somehow. once this process is done, you can open a command prompt. You can see that some words here are not matching yours because I'm using an international version in Portuguese, but this is the same. The commands in the prompt are the same you use in English and using the English ones. So don't worry, this is the command prompt. And you you point to the place you have packaged your project. So when you package your project, you create a folder called Windows No Editor. You just have to enter by your prompt here. You see that I'm here, downloads, build, Windows No Editor. And you need to run the executable. Now, we have finished packaging here. You must see build is successful. If you are not seeing this, it's because your project has some issues that you could track in this output log. But I will tell you one thing that I had already fixed, and it is in the ships and examples. Man of War, it is our largest ship here, and that is the blueprint. You have to open it, and you see that this piece of code here, ship steering by using torque, you see that this function here is marked as going to be obsolete. It's just add torque. So the output log here, if you go after it, you see that they are asking you to change this function to or add torque in radians or add torque in degrees. I haven't time to check the math and to see what I use here. So I have used the first option. It is the add torque in radians. Okay, so I'm not sure if it is you have issues or not. If it's not the correct one, I think it will cause problems. But anyway, it's just for you to be able to compile and then package again. Our is okay. You can now close your project. Otherwise, you'll be very heavy in your machine. So you can close it. And once you open your command prompt, you just need to execute your file. So you have a small window because we asked for this. If you didn't add anything else, you just alt tab so you can deselect your game window so you can move it. And inside this window, as you guys can see if I can put inside something off. You have to type your console key, which will open the console. What you have to do is isolate the map, question mark. So now, this is acting in and you listen for incoming connections for clients. So right now, everything looks okay. We are here to see if the player or reflections in this water will be correct. We have an user in our forms that's split screen, which means we have a screen that is the same process. same process, so it never replaces the packet inside the same process. It and can't. So now Alt Tab to go again to your command prompt, and you execute again, opening up. I have set the time loop. Processes in the same machine, we have to tell the IP this is the loopback IP. If you're running in a different machine, you have to look for the IP. So when you hit enter, we have just connected. See, they are getting in both screens. It looks like the daytime is you see, we were daylight in the screen, and now we are nighttime. You see that we are seeing this screen in the moon. You see, in the first screen, the moon going at the same time as the moon. Executable and see if the moon is right. Very good. Okay. They set exactly the same time. So it seems that the solution can't handle connections when you have split screen. Now I don't know if this is something easy to fix or if it's a bug. For networking, we are having the same technical here because to see if the wave is the same. Guys, enjoy this and be sure to share this product. It's awesome if you have it already. check on everyone.